Hello, I'm Gavin Hoey, and in this video I'm going to show you how to create professional looking proof books using Photoshop. But before we go anywhere near Photoshop, it really helps to get organised. So I've already copied the pictures that I want to put into my proof book, and I've put them into their own separate folder. So they're all ready to go. Now, let's go into Photoshop and make the pages. We'll go to File, Automate, and Contact Sheet 2. Now you need to set a few things up on this to get it to work correctly. First thing you need to do is tell Photoshop where that folder is that contains your proof images. So we'll click Browse, and then we'll go and find the folder. Now I pop mine on my desktop. I find that's a really good place to put temporary things. Now we need to tell it what size our proof book is going to be, so the size of each individual sheet of paper. Now you can choose any size you like in theory, but I'm going to stick to a nice simple 6 inches by 4 inches. It's a nice small portable size, and you can also get this printed pretty much anywhere on the high street. You can use your own printer as well, and it doesn't cost too much for a 6 by 4 inch print. I'm also going to ask it to flatten all the layers. Now if you don't do that, then your images are going to be made up of multiple layers. It doesn't matter, but it just keeps your images a bit more simple. Now we come down to the thumbnails. Now thumbnails are actually the individual images in your proof book. So let's start off by saying use auto spacing. That just makes life a little bit easier for us. And then we can decide how many pictures per page. Now at the moment we've got 10 in the columns and 5 in the rows. So that's columns, which are the up and down ones, and then rows, which are the across ones. So 10 pictures per column and 5 per row. Now that's 50 pictures per page. Now that's rather a lot. In fact, that's far too many. I prefer to have just 4 images on a 6 by 4 inch print. That gives a pretty good size. They're very viewable at that size, but they're not overly big. So let's change that to 2 in the columns and 2 in the width. And you can see up here on our little preview that we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 pictures. The last thing to do on this section is to click Rotate for best fit. Now I'm also going to use the file names as captions. There's no point making a proof book if you don't put the names of the pictures. If you want a client to order or at least know what the pictures are, you need to tell them what they are, and this is where you do it. There's almost nothing you can change here. You can change the font, but it only lets you have a choice of 3 fonts, so we might as well stick with Arial. And 12 point is about the right size. It's normal size print, nice and clear and easy to read. And then all you need to do is to click OK. And then Photoshop starts whizzing around on the screen, getting all the images from your folder, combining them into one sheet, and then repeating it for all the other sheets. Now I've got 16 images in that folder, so it should make 4 sheets of paper. Now obviously the more images you have, the longer it's going to take to work. But that looks pretty good. There we go. It's now done its job. And we can see that we have nice big images. You can see that the portrait ones have been rotated, so they are the same size, but you need to turn them over to see them. And of course the text is in underneath as well, so we can see exactly the name of each of the pictures. Now if you're getting somebody else to print your pictures off, you can save these as individual files and send them to your printer. But if you're going to be doing home printing, you're probably going to be printing them at A4. Now I don't want to print an A4 piece of paper with one small 6x4 inch image in the middle, so I'm going to combine multiple sheets together to make one large sheet that's ready for printing. And we can get 4 of these little 6x4s on an A4 sheet. Well, nearly. We have to shrink it slightly, but we'll do that at the end. Now we're going to need to trim these out afterwards, so I'm going to come up and choose Select, Select All, and then Edit and Stroke. I'm just going to stroke the inside by 1 pixel. Now the purpose of this is to give you a trim line so you know where to cut this out once you've printed it out. And then we need to make more space for the rest of the other sheets to go on. So we're going to come up to Image, Canvas Size, and we're going to increase the canvas size by twice its dimensions. Now I prefer to set my units to percent to do this because I find mathematics much easier that way. So 200% is obviously twice as big in all directions. And we need to anchor it into any of the corner points. It doesn't matter which one, as long as it's one in a corner. Okay, like so. So now we have room for 1, 2, 3 more sheets. Okay, so let's get another sheet and we'll repeat the steps we did at the beginning, select and select all, edit and stroke. So we've added a trim line around the edge, and then we can just drag that using the move tool and drop it straight onto our big sheet, like so. Okay, let's get rid of that one. We don't need that now. And we've got two more to go, so we'll do the same again. Select, select all, edit and stroke, and drag and drop that one on as well. And then that leaves one last one, so select and select all, edit and stroke, and drop that in as well. Now, if you've got lots of these to do, I can highly recommend making an action to do those last few steps, because it'll save you a lot of time. But as we've only got four sheets, I can just about manage that as it is. Okay, that's lovely. We'll just move these around, get this in the right place. That's it. And it goes up there. Good. Okay, so there we are. We now have all the sheets on one large sheet, and we're ready to send this to the printer to be printed out. So I need to rotate it, otherwise it won't come out the printer properly. Rotate it 90 degrees, like that. And then we'll go to File and Print. Now, as I say, this is slightly larger than an A4 sheet of paper. So there's a little button down here that says Scaled Print Size, Scale to Fit to Media. So we're going to do that. Click that little button and it scales it to fit onto your largest size, which is almost certainly A4 sheet of paper. Okay, so all you need to do now is just to click the print button and you'll print that off your printer, and we're ready to start trimming. So all I need to do now is to trim up the pages using those guidelines we created in Photoshop. And then to create a very professional looking finish, I like to bind my pages together using a ring binder. And that should give a secure and professional look.